Mother?
Let me go. Let me go, Yanimal. Let me go.
Mother?
Let me go. Let me go.
Mother?
Let me go. You're a monster, the child of a beast.
Mother, it's just me. What's happening to you? Why are you saying that I'm a monster?
What?
Mother?
Mening Ning, no. I said, I want gin. Get me a bottle. Hurry. Come on.
Hold on, hold on. Calm down, okay? You just stay here for now. I'm just going out to talk to Habagat.
No, but what if he gets mad at me? Don't do it, please.
He doesn't have the right to get mad at you. It's all his fault anyway. Isn't he supposed to be helping you? If he wanted to help, this is not the way to do it. Right? This is wrong. Stay here, okay?
Hey, Eric, what in the world happened to my Jeep's bumper? Tell me what happened.
I fell asleep behind the wheel, sir. I really didn't mean to wreck your Jeep's bumper.
You what? You were sleeping behind the wheel? What were you thinking? Now who's going to pay for all the repairs?
Give me a break.
Do you have the money for this?
No, I don't. I'm broke. I have no money at all.
Then you should have thought of that. You should have been more careful with it, Eric.
Can I at least get paid for today?
What, are you kidding? That's not enough. Fixing a Jeep costs more than what you earn. This is all your fault. That's going to cost me so much money. You know what? You're fired. Don't you ever come back here. Get lost. Get out of here.
Boom, 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 boom. Police, police in the house.
In the house.
Better run or get arrested.
Arrested.
All the girls want to get him.
Yeah, what?
There he is with his guns blazing.
Guns blazing.
The police. There
he's
he
amazing.
Is. He's amazing.
Amazing.
And the now police. He's back. Here he comes. Officer Armand Arellano.
Game, game.
Hey, man, how was it? Was she hot? Man, what's happening? You're not even sweaty.
He just asked for a quick timeout. He'll be back for more, all right? Tell us, Armand, did you like your graduation gift?
Did you have any idea that she's a minor? You know that I can arrest you for that crime.
Oh, I'm fully aware that she's a minor. You're that special to us. So, is she a virgin? If she isn't, I can look for somebody else. You want?
Hey, hey, wait, wait, stay there, stay there, hey, wait.
What's your problem? What's the matter with you? What?
You're an animal. That girl who'll be spending the night with me, she's just a minor. She's a young and innocent girl.
So what if she's a minor, Armand? What makes you think you've done nothing wrong? Admit it, you were excited to bring your graduation gift to your room. We're all men here, Armand.
I'm not claiming
so what's
any
the problem?
Here.
Really?
But you just tell me, what are you doing?
What?
Are you
Please.
Really trying to help her? Is that what you call
yes,
help?
Yes, I'm helping
by
her. She
her
said
up as a
yes.
Prostitute? Are you crazy?
No,
wait, wait.
You think you're better than me?
Enough.
Get over here.
I said stop.
Stop fighting.
Guys.
I said you two stop fighting.
Let go of me.
You two stop this. Stop this. I'm telling you two to
breathe.
Stop this. What in the world are you two fighting? What? Do you really want to kill each other off?
Go ask him. You can ask that policeman friend of yours over there. He's the
You're
one who started
this
whole thing.
You really have no respect for women. You sick.
No respect for women? And what do you mean by that?
It's nothing. It's just Sandy. It's nothing. We were just hanging out with the boys and then we saw these two fighting.
You can see that they're already fighting. You didn't even do anything to stop them.
No, we've been trying to stop them, but they pushed us out of the way.
So you still want to fight? Okay, let them do it. Let's see who's going to go down first. Go ahead. Go on. Start throwing your punches. So? What's stopping you two? If you want to fight, then go ahead. Don't stop. Go kill yourselves for all I care. You can start by being like Eric, who let his temper get the best of him. I thought you were stronger than this. Now go on! Come on, let's see some fighting. You, Armin, you shouldn't be an honorable policeman. But what are you doing? You started a fight? And I thought that you wanted to be a policeman because you wanted to change your life. It looks like there isn't any change at all. As for you, Habagat, what is wrong with you? Don't you have any respect for women? Do you have any respect left for me? Your sister? What? And that goes for you, too. What are you here for? Something much worse could have happened. You didn't stop them. What's wrong with you? And I really thought that all of us are friends in this neighborhood. But what is going on now?
We were really trying to, but they wouldn't listen.
All right. You want to continue this stupidity? You can start tearing each other's heads off now. Go ahead. Hurry. Kill each other for all I care. Come on. What? What? Do you still want to go on with this, or do you want to work it out? Fix this, or else I promise I'll hit you both. I really will do it.
Come on, guys.
Yes.
Enough
of
this.
Stop, okay? Shake hands.
You are really getting me tired. You just work it out.
Hey, that's enough.
Come on. I said enough. Stop this. Stop. Stop. Break it up, both of you. Okay, you have to look for Eric now. Hurry. I really can't
come
stop
here.
These two. Stop it.
Armin,
come here.
Armin, stop it.
Stop it.
Daphne.
Not now, Grandmother, please.
Why did you totally ignore all of my instructions? I already told you that they're all very important. The client called, and he was very disappointed. Are you really that irresponsible?
You know very well you can't trust me with these things. You could have done it all by yourself, so please stop putting the blame on me.
Eleanor, you have to talk to that daughter of yours. It's that mouth of hers. It's getting so much worse. Is that what she learned from you?
Oh, Mother. I'm not related to Daphne. If she has a bad attitude, it's not because of me. Maybe it's because of her blood.
Madam? Am I going to lock the door or water the plants?
It's a good thing that I still have my regular job to pay for Brian's tuition. I don't know what I'm going to do. I can't believe that your mind wasn't on the wheel. That was careless. You're lucky that nothing bad happened to you. That you didn't hit anybody.
I didn't mean it. It was an accident, Mother.
Now drink that to get sober.
I'm already sober. But I'm just really depressed now. I saw Manning again with that Charles.
And you're jealous, right? Why then, you're really out of your mind. Eric, come on, haven't you learned to trust Manning? You know what? I believe that she loves you. Why don't you start trusting her? That's what you should learn to do, Eric. Go ahead, drink up. It's like I always say, Eric. Do you know that love is much like hot coffee?
Coffee?
Yes.
Mother, I don't have time for that kind of talk. That doesn't apply to me at all.
You're butting in. Let me finish. As I was saying, love is like a cup of hot coffee. What it needs is the right sweetness. If there's not enough sugar, then it becomes too bitter. But if you put too much sugar and leave it lying, a lot of ants will be all over it. Love is like that. Wasn't it good? Go on, drink it up. Eric, if you're not drunk, what happened? How'd you get into that accident?
Well, it's Lilybeth's fault. She...
Lilybeth? You were with a woman? Wow, what have you been doing, Eric? What are you getting yourself
it's
into?
It's nothing. Nothing.
Eric.
Mother.
Eric, Eric.
Mother.
If you really want to get back with Manning, you should clean up your act first. You've been stubborn ever since. When are you going to change? You won't get back together with Manning Ning if you're like that. I have to go and do the laundry.
Among. Among, you've been with us for a long time, am I right?
Yes, madam.
You have spent a long time under my roof, right?
Yes, madam.
You tell me, Have you noticed anything strange happening in this house?
Yes, madam, I have. I noticed something different. Something about you.
What do you mean?
Because I've been seeing you staring at blank spaces as if you were bitten by a snake.
A snake? Who got bitten by a snake? Is that what you're saying?
Oh, wait. Madam, are you sure you're feeling okay? I was wondering if you were going out of your mind, madam.
Leave me alone now.
Yes, madam. Aren't you joining your friends at Armand's? You should be joining their little party, right?
Maybe I'll follow them in a while. I just need to get some rest.
Hey, Eric! Manining is asking for your help.
What is it?
There's a fight. Armand and Habagat. They're trying to kill each other.
Where are they?
Your turn. They're fighting at Armand's place.
Busset, are you sure about this?
Yes!
What's happening? Who's fighting who? You boys stay
Mother,
here.
I have to go.
I'm going with you, Eric. Wait for me. You boys stay in the house.
Oh, honey. What happened to the face of your son?
Oh.
What?
Nothing to worry about, Father. It's all worth it because I got to spend time with the woman I love today.
Oh, Daphne.
No, Father. Maning Ning.
Get a hold of yourself. What's with you? Is crying the best thing that you can do to fight this? What does this mean? Are you going to let yourself be beaten by Maning Ning? You have to keep calm. Remember that crying won't solve your problems. You need to create a solution.
What should I do, Mother? How do I beat her? What am I going to do if she takes Charles away from me, Mother?
I have already thought about it. And I have the solution. Pretend to be friends with Maning Ning. You really have to stay close to her.
What do I do if she discovers that we're sisters? Mother, I don't want to share anything with her. I don't like sharing anything with her.
Daphne, that's why you have to be in control of your emotions. Other than that, once you two become the best of friends, you will know all of her weaknesses. And you'll now know the reasons why Charles has a special liking to her. When you find that out, that is what we're going to use against that sister of yours. Do you understand?
Yes, Mother.
You should wipe your tears. They're making you ugly.
I want to see her more, but I'll do something about it.
Well, if you want to, go ahead.
Hello. Are you there? Hello? Hello?
Mother? Who are you calling?
Honey, can you make that call later? We're still eating dinner.
I'm sorry, honey. It slipped my mind for a moment.
That's all right. Let's eat.
It's all your fault!
Hey! Bukol!
Why did you two stop? You're all afraid of gunshots, huh?
Hey, what's going on here?
These friends of yours won't stop their stupid fighting. Looks like they needed to hear gunshots so that they'd stop.
Armin, Habagat. What's gotten into you both? You don't even listen to Meningning. Show her some respect. What's wrong with you? We all grew up here. We should stick together, right?
What? Do you want to hear me fire another shot? Huh? Don't push me to do this. You know that I won't hesitate. You hear me? Huh?
Sorry, Meningning.
I'm sorry.
I know that both of you need to cool your temper first, before you talk again. Take time to sober up from all the drinks you just had, do you understand?
Meningning, can we talk?
And that goes for you too, Eric. We're leaving, Habagat. Come on, let's go home.
Oh my.
That scared me for a minute.
Hey, Bukol, Octopus, you can go home now. Drinking session is over.
You chose a bad time to do that, Eric. Just when Meningning is trying to fix a problem, you butt in.
She has a lot of things on her mind. She can't talk to you right now. You weren't listening to me. Come on, we're going home. Hurry.
Armand, I hope you're okay. It's just too bad that this had to happen.
It's okay.
Habagat, who is this Sandy? And why are you fighting Armand? What's that all about?
Oh, it's nothing. For his celebration, we just decided to give Armand our gift, and we thought that a girl would be perfect.
You what? You gave her as a gift? What are you thinking? You're the one who's crazy.
Ow.
Don't you have any respect for women? Do you have any respect for me and Mother? Do you think that women are just gifts that you can give? The next time that I catch you treating women like that, I'm going to have you disowned. You understand me?
Sorry, Meningning. It won't happen again.
All right. Don't you ever tell Mother about this, okay? Do it and I'll be the one who'll beat you up.
Yes.
Get inside and take a bath. You stubborn kid.
Sandy? Why aren't you staying in your room? Did you see everything?
I thought that something bad happened. I'm sorry for getting you and Habagat in a fight. Everything is my fault.
No, you don't have to blame yourself. After everything that happened, I think that we're gonna be okay.
Are you sure that you two are okay?
No need to worry about that. We'll talk someday, but maybe it's not yet the right time.
Looks like Habagat is mad at me. Where am I going to stay?
If you want, you can stay here with me. I'm all alone in this house anyway.
Really? What am I going to do here?
Don't worry. I won't do anything to hurt you. Oh, there. I have a spare room where you can sleep. It's all yours. And you told me that you don't have a family, right? Then I could be your family from now on. That is, if it's okay with you.
That's okay. You seem like a nice man.
Don't worry. You're living under my roof. Nothing will happen to you.
I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you. I just lost myself. Maybe I got carried away because of my feelings for you.
You shouldn't be asking me for forgiveness, Daphne. You should go to Meningning. You accused her of something that is completely false. She was innocent.
I know. That's why I'm asking for your help. I want to talk to her and personally apologize. I feel bad about it myself.
Are you serious? Or just plain sarcastic? It's no joke to ask for forgiveness, Daphne.
I'm serious, Charles. I know that I made a big mistake. Besides, you were able to be a good friend to her. Maybe I can do that too. Charles, you told me
that will talk, right? But right now, I'm the only one doing the talking. Are we still okay?
Daphne, let's just be friends for now, okay?
But why? I thought we were okay. What do you want me to do? I already apologized.
Like I said before, there's nothing you have to do. It's me who should apologize to you. I know that I led you on. And I'm sorry that I took advantage of you. But I think it's better for the both of us now to be just good friends.
Emang? Emang, Bini, come here with me.
Yes, madam.
We're coming.
You're coming.
I have a question for you. You tell me the truth.
Yes, madam.
You first, Emang.
Yes, madam, I'm first.
Where are you from and who are your parents?
I came from the province. Esmeralda is the name of my mother, and Diego is the name of my father.
Are you sure?
I'm sure, madam.
You, Bining, same question.
I am from the province too, madam. Both of my parents are dead. They are Pacundo and Juanita.
Is this the truth?
Yes, madam, that is the truth.
And where are the laundry women?
You're looking for Mirna and Maningning? They're probably on their way here.
Hey, have you heard about the huge snake that they saw in Karya's house? It's big!
Really?
It scared the life out of me!
This guy's kidding, huh? I don't believe you.
You probably took a lot of bets there.
How did you know, Harry?
All your bets are placed on number 8. If that number comes up, we'll be losing a lot of money.
Harry, the police! They're here!
Go close the door!
What bad timing!
Get rid of everything!
Don't leave anything!
Let's go!
Hurry,
let's go!
Hurry up!
Good morning, madam.
Mirna, Maningning. Okay, you may go. Here, I have a question to you both.
Yes, what is it?
You first. Mirna. Where are you from and who are your parents?
I just live by the pier. I was young when both of my parents died. The only thing that I remember are their names. It's Josie and Mario.
And you, Maningning, same question.
I also live along the pier. Mirna and I live in the same neighborhood. My father died when I was young. His name is Joel. As for my mother, she's still alive. She's doing okay. Her name is Virgie.
Virgie? Virgie? Does she know that you're working here?
That's a bit of a problem. She doesn't know that I'm doing laundry for money.
All right. You can go back to work.
Yes, madam.
Oh, wait, Mirna. Why is she like that? She's acting really strange. She's weird.
You said it, Maningning. If not for the high salary, I would have quit by now.
Maybe she has rabies. Be careful.
Mirna, shh.
This cannot be. I have to be sure. I have to be sure that nobody knows. Past is past.
Police raids are happening left and right. It's a good thing that policemen can be bribed. Are you doing your job, Harry? I've done a lot to build your reputation to my boss.
Sorry about that, boss. Things didn't go as planned. I didn't expect that little police raid. But you know me, right? I know that I'm up for it. Just give me more time. We won't be having any problems with the police.
All right, you can go.
Okay, boss. I'm really sorry.
Wow, that smells good. Oh, I'm sorry about the shirt you're wearing. Don't worry. When I get back from work, I'll buy you one. I'll just get your size.
Thank you.
Oh. Go on and eat.
Okay. Hey, come join me. Go on. Delicious. Wait, did I leave you any money for this? Where'd you get it?
Oh, I just cooked some of the leftover from last night.
Leftover from last night? This is so much better.
Oh, come on. Stop teasing me.
It's good. It's better than last night. Here, you should try it. Well, am I right?
Maningning?
Charles is not here.
I know.
Then what do you want? You want to pick a fight with me?
I'm not here to fight. It's you that I came to visit. I just wanted to apologize for the things that I've done to you. I'm sorry.
Let's just forget it. It's over. I have a lot of things to do.
One more thing you must know. I really want to be friends with you.
You want to be friends with me? Are you sure? I thought that you didn't want to be around stinking people like me.
I'm sorry. I just got carried away because of my feelings for Charles. Maningning, I love Charles. I hope you can understand that. But you don't have anything to worry about me. I just really want us to be good friends.
Are you sure? Do you really want me to be your friend?
Of course. Why shouldn't I be friends with you, right? Friends?
Friends. Let's just talk some other time. I really still have a lot of things to do.
Okay, see ya.
Have you talked to Armand?
No, not yet.
Not yet? Are you still mad at him? Come on. Let it go. Try to understand him. He's been like that since we were kids. Come on, get over it. We know that he's the one that tipped Bogle to the police. That's why he shouldn't know anything about our business. We'll have a big problem. That would be a complete disaster. But Armand is still our friend.
That's just it. We're all friends, but he's willing to throw away our friendship over some girl. Well, that's messed up.
It might be wrong, but think about it. Are you willing to ruin our friendship over a woman?
Of course not. Armand and I can work it out. We'll forget about that soon. But what makes me angry is Sandy. We were trying to help her out, but we get into trouble.
If I were you, you shouldn't be wasting your time and energy over that girl. You know what? Let's just get some work done so we'll get a lot of money, right?
More money for partying.
Are you finished? Is everything okay?
I'm almost done, but I haven't finished washing your clothes.
That will do.
Madam?
Here's your money. You can leave now.
But madam, I'm not yet finished, and this is bigger than the usual amount.
Did you not hear me? I said you can now leave. You're fired. You don't work here anymore. Okay, you may go.
Mother? Oh,
and why are you home early?
Class is finished early today. Where are you going? Are you going to collect bets again?
Yes, why?
I'm going to go with you.
Why? Where are you headed?
To the fish port, Mother. There might be some fish left that I can still sell there.
All right. Hurry up, okay? Because I need to catch up on collecting bets.
Yes, Mother.
Hey, Cheetah.
Hey, Buko! What brings you here?
Hey, how are you? Looks like business is doing good. That sure is a lot.
Well, I'm not yet finished collecting from the others. I'm still short.
That's still short?
Oh, yes. Why?
Oh, it's nothing. I was just thinking. Have you eaten lunch?
Yes, I've already eaten.
Oh, it's,
Why do you ask?
It's already late. It's already late in the afternoon, and I haven't eaten breakfast. Maning Ning wasn't there to prepare it. I was thinking of Talet's delicious dishes that I can't even buy, because I'm short on cash. I'm just having a hard time concentrating on work and anything when I'm
feeling hungry.
This is nice, but it's not really enough for a heavy meal. I was thinking of having some extra orders, maybe soda. I'd really appreciate if you could spare me some more for my dinner.
Okay, here. Take this. This will be your last, okay? You're
Cheetah,
trying to trick me, huh?
You're the best. Thank you.
Hey, wait. And where do you think you're going?
Is that it? I'm really, really hungry.
How much did I give you? That's quite a lot. Before you go, don't I get a kiss?
Oh, come on. I'm really hungry, and you're making me lose my appetite. I have to go.
Here, take this. This might help you change your mind. Come on.
Oh, wait a minute.
Paul.
Sir.
How are you?
I'm just fine.
Excuse us, okay?
Excuse us. Let's talk there, sir. How are you?
Oh, good. How about you?
Oh.
Happy?
Yes. Very much. I'm happy with my job. Do you have an assignment for me? What brings you here?
I'm just fixing a transaction near your place. I just wanted to bring you along so that you'll know the operations.
Oh, is that so? Okay. Anything for you, sir.
Okay, have you had lunch?
I was just about to, but I can't. I'm really hungry, but I don't have the money to buy some food.
Let's go.
Really? Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Do you know a good restaurant here?
She serves the best food around here.
Hey, wait. Really? Who called?
Let's go.
Bhagat, can you please help me?
Help you? Why are you asking for my help?
Well, it's because...
What? What is it? Hurry, I'll have to go in a few minutes.
The stove. The stove is on fire.
Of course it is. It's how you cook food.
The stove in the kitchen. It's burning. I can't put it off. The entire house is burning.
Why did you say so? What's wrong with you?
Canned goods, rice, what else? Shirt. I'm not sure I can afford all this.
Raliano, we have an operation at midnight tonight. Our chief said that we should go home to get some rest.
Where are we going, sir?
He didn't say where, but there will be a briefing later.
Okay. Sir, are you going home?
Yes, need a lift?
Yes, but I need to go to the plaza. I have to buy some things before going home.
All right, let's go. Come on.
Thank you, sir.
Let's go.
Eric, what are you doing there? Where's your jeep? Aren't you supposed to be working?
No, I just got fired. I crashed my boss's jeep, and he fired me on the spot.
You got fired? Why? Is it because of what happened yesterday?
Yes.
That's what I've been telling you from the start. You have a hot temper. See what happens? That's what you get.
Yes, you're right. And how is your friend Charles? Did he get mad at you because of me?
Charles? He's not like that. You're lucky that he's kind. He said that he forgives you, Eric. And he also told me that that's how men really are.
What about you?
I don't have a choice. All right, can we talk later? I have to go. I have to sell some fish.
Wait a minute. Isn't it your day to do laundry with mother?
Well, I just got fired by Charles's mother.
Why? Was it because of me?
No, I'm figuring it out myself. She wouldn't explain. And Myrna said that she's really like that. She's very weird. Maybe she just wanted to pick on me.
Oh, that's okay. That's what mother told me. Since I don't have anything to do today, maybe I can go with you.
Well, it's up to you.
Sandy, here are the shirts that I bought for you. Here, try it on and see if it looks good on you. Habagat, what are you doing here?
Arman, the stove was on fire. That's why Habagat is here. He helped me out. The house could have burned down if it wasn't for him. It's good that Habagat got here. Thank you very much, Habagat.
This is all your fault.
Habagat. Thank you. Are you all right? Okay. I'll go prepare our food for tonight.
Hey, Bukol.
Oh, sir, this is
Here's
too
your
much.
Money.
Wow, that looks
that's
really
nothing.
Delicious.
Hey, Bukol, what is that? What did Sir Sigmund give you?
Wow, that's a lot of money.
This is to cover my tip. Because I carried the fish to Sir Sigmund's car. It was really heavy, wasn't it, sir?
Yes, that's right.
I had to go back and forth and bring all of it
Sorry
to his
car. Sorry
about
that, Maningning. I thought you weren't coming. I was supposed to buy them from you, but you weren't here.
No, it's all my fault, sir. I should have been here to assist you. I could have given you a better price. Next time, I'll be on the lookout for you.
That's right.
Come on, it's nothing. Who is this boy? Is he your boyfriend?
Oh, that's a very good question, sir. Our friends are trying to figure that out, too. These two are always fighting. Sometimes they're okay, sometimes they're not.
By the way, sir, my name is Eric.
Eric.
Hey, are you sure that this isn't some scam to get some easy money? You might be taking advantage of Sir Sigmund's kindness here.
No way, of course
not. Sure, Bukol? That's not like you.
Sir, they're ganging
Looks
up on
like
me.
Looks like Maningning's the boss around here.
She is, sir.
I'll beat you up.
No need to worry, Maningning. I can assure you that Bukol's a good boy. Right, Bukol?
Of course, sir. What I tell you.
Okay, since I didn't get to buy anything from you, let's make a deal. Join me for a snack. You could also come along, Eric.
Oh,
really?
Oh, thank
wow,
you.
That's very kind of you.
Come on. Oh.
All right, come on.
Shh, Bukol, stop saying that.
Come on.
Okay, where are we going?
It's up to you. Should
we go to the
restaurant
around
here?
Her snacks there are great.
We're going there again. We can always
okay.
eat there.
Let's try,
can
another,
we try
place.
Another place.
Hey, Mang.
Oh, sir.
Can you prepare my breakfast, please?
All right.
I'll be eating here.
Hi, Charles. Hey.
You've already made this province your favorite getaway. We're not really going out. Why exactly are you here?
I wasn't here to visit you. I'm here to see Maningning.
Wow, you're really something, Daphne. And I thought you wanted to pick a fight.
Of course not. Didn't I tell you that I want her to be my friend? I'm sincere. In fact, after work, we're going to do some shopping.
And to think that I thought you were making all that up while we were talking in the restaurant.
No.
You're really serious?
Yes.
Hey, Mang?
Yes, sir, just a minute.
Is Maningning coming into work?
Oh, Sir Charles. Looks like Maningning won't be coming here to do the laundry. Your mother just fired her.
What? But why?
She didn't give her reasons. She suddenly told Maningning that she can leave. Really? That's too bad. I'm just starting to like her.
I did good. My guess is correct. Maningning is the daughter of Virgi. Well, now she's out of my life. And she won't be disturbing me anymore. Hello, who's this?
So you paid a visit to your friend. Why didn't you talk to her? Why did you hesitate?
Harry? Is that you? What do you want from me? Answer me!
Relax, Rosa. You're getting too paranoid. Don't worry. We'll be talking again.
Mael, take that. Oh, Rosa! Okay, you could bring that to the car. I'll catch up. It's nice to see you.
I need your advice very badly, Violeta.
All right, what can I do to help?
I have a stalker.
Oh, dear.
He's stalking me, but I cannot stop him.
He knows my every move. But I cannot see him, even in the morning.
Do you have any idea who this stalker is?
Yes, I have an idea.
Okay, tell me, who's bothering you?
Oh, someone from my past that I want to get away from. What should I do, Violeta?
Come on, Rosa. If you're not going to tell me who this stalker is, then there's only one thing to do. Why don't you get a bodyguard? That would be better so that there will be somebody to keep an eye on you.
Of course. Why, that is a brilliant idea. Why didn't I think of that?
Thank you. Right, do Thank that, you. Okay? For now, let me all escort right. you all the way home.
All right, we'll
so
use
safe.
Your bodyguard.
Sure. Okay, let's go.
How are you, Sigmund?
Where is it?
So you know Meng Ning. This is great. It's all falling into place.
Mother!
Hey, he looks so happy. What's the good news?
She's out. She is out.
Who was out?
Meng Ning, Mother. She's no longer working in Charles's house. Rosa fired her.
Oh, really? Oh, that's good news. We should celebrate. You know, I think we still have wine in the dining room. We should drink to your success. Come on.
Okay, let's go.
I just heard that police raided your place the other day. How do we go on with business?
We're still operating.
Isn't it dangerous?
I've already thought about that. That's what I wanted to show you. Look there.
They look familiar. These men were with you the other day in the gambling hideout.
You really have a keen eye. Yes, you're right. They're the ones with me in the hideout.
So this is what we'll ride going to the new hideout?
No. This is our new place. Welcome to our new hideout. Didn't you mention that the police keep on raiding our meeting place? Why don't we just draw the numbers here and they won't suspect our operations? Now tell me, what do you think?
Wow, you're really good. You should be promoted.
Go on, get in.
In here?
Meng Ning, why are you here? Why didn't you go with Mother to do the laundry in the mansion?
I don't work there anymore.
Why? They don't like you anymore?
I don't know.
It's okay, Pusit. It's great. It just means that we'll get to spend more time with my lovely Meng Ning. When she started working there, she stopped cooking for us already.
Why? Did you miss my cooking?
Yes.
All right, just stay nice and I'll be your regular cook, okay?
Is that a promise, Meng Ning?
I promise.
I'm just in time. This is great. You guys are already eating. For you, Meng Ning.
Eric, hey, what are you doing?
Nothing. I just thought I could get away with that. For you.
Thank you.
Eric, you can stop dreaming. Meng Ning has feelings for me now. She loves me now. Just accept it. You've been giving her the same gift. Eric, don't you think Meng Ning is getting sick of that?
You should just get used to Eric by now. You know that he doesn't spend too much. He's a bit tight on money.
Hey, you're embarrassing me.
By the way, how are you? Are you still looking for work?
Still nothing. My former boss spread the story about what happened with his jeep. No one wants to get me now.
That's okay. Who knows? Both of us might get jobs at the same time, right?
I hope.
Mother, why did you fire Meng Ning?
Oh, because I want to.
Because why? You wanted to? How could you fire Meng Ning without any reasons, Mother?
Well...
Did she do something wrong? Just give me one reason why you fired her. Just one.
Baby boy.
Is she the reason why you've been acting kind of weird lately?